It's the first time, like, in the history of the United States, natural gas prices separated from gasoline. This was an opportunity to get natural gas vehicles into our infrastructure and seriously displace foreign oil in a big way. The problem is, you know, when was the last time you saw a natural gas refueling station? So the idea behind the MOVE program was basically lower the cost of refueling by enabling home refueling, so low cost at home compressors. And the second part of it was dropping the cost of the tank. So REL is a great project. Two brothers up in Upper Peninsula, Michigan. What they do, no one else in the world can do.
When someone says, that's impossible, we say, well, when would you like it done? The purpose of the ARPA-E project, working with REL, is to provide a conformable fuel tank. Conventionally, when we store gas at high pressure, we use cylindrical geometry. That's nature's shape for storing high pressure gases. We take and put our cylindrical tanks in the trunk. Well, as soon as you do that, you can't put your groceries in. With a conformable design, with the box, we can pack fuel more efficiently inside of a vehicle. So I need to fill up somewhere, which brings up the second part of the natural gas problem, is the infrastructure to fuel up while you're on the road.
60 million homes have natural gas. So in a sense, we have an infrastructure for natural gas, but we can't tap into it. And that's where Oregon State came up with the concept of simply taking an engine and taking one of the cylinders and turning it into a compressor.
You would pull up at your home or your place of business where you have a natural gas supply line, and you would connect it to that compressor cylinder on the engine. So essentially, the compressor capability is on board the vehicle, not outside. What's innovative about this technology here is that we're able to leverage the modern internal combustion engine technology that's available to us today and incorporate the compression combustion technologies into one engine. Not only are they a catalyst, they also provide the critical funding in order to advance these types of energy technologies and make them available to everybody. And so ARPA-E has the capability to step in and play that important, critical C-funding role.
ARPA-E understands that innovation comes from small business. They have a higher level view of the overall problem, but they also have the technical savvy to look at all the projects and understand the viability of the technology involved, as well as how all the teams will integrate together.
If we can diversify our portfolio of energy sources for transportation sector, this would be a big win. Not to mention that natural gas is much cleaner burning fuel. This is 100% to the country's benefit.